Okay, what we're going to do next here today is we are going to be looking at a histogram, and what we'd like to do is take this data and convert it and be able to make a box plot of the information that's here. The histogram tells us great things about the frequency. It can give us some general ideas. The box plot gives us very specific information about how the data is broken down. The advantage, again, of the box plot, or box and whisker plot, we use both names, is the fact that it can, at a glance, we can find what the maximum and minimum values of the graph are, and we can also locate what Q1 and Q3 and the median of the graph are, and those are very evident when you're looking at them. We can take the data that's given in a histogram, in particular here, where each range is just equal to one value, and we can use that to go in and actually find all of these values, and we can use our calculator to do that. Notice at this point what we have is we have a graph of the number of pets per household, and we'd like to make a box and whisker plot of the number of pets and be able to talk about their frequencies. Now, in this particular case, when we're trying to do this information, what we'd like to be able to do is we want to enter these scores. Now, basically, if according to what we've learned before, we can put all of this in to our calculators and have it find that five-number summary for us. However, you have to hand enter every single data point. In this case, we can see it by looking at the graph here that 0 would have to be entered 4 times, 1 would have to be entered 9 times, 2 would have to be entered 6 times, and so we actually get this thing going on and on and on, which is a little bit more difficult. So what we can do instead is we can go in and use a frequency, kind of basically put a frequency table that would reflect this into our calculator. So if we go in the stat button, we're going to choose edit because this is where we put all of our data in. Notice I've already got some information in here from L1, so I need to kind of clear that out before I start. So I use the up arrow to go up here, I hit the clear button, I hit enter, and poof, I'm all cleaned out and ready to enter my new data. Now, for this particular example, L1, what I put in here is what I'm actually trying to measure. In this case, it's how many pets per household. So I have all of these options here of 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, oops, let's try that again, 5, 6, and 7. So those are just the bottom values here for my axes. Now when I go up here, what I'd like to do is put the frequency here. That way I don't have to type in 0 4 times and I don't have to type in 1 9 times. It's real easy to make mistakes there. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to say, okay, well, 0 is the solution, but it has a frequency of 4. It happens 4 times. I want it to count 1 9 times. I want it to count 2 6 times. I want it to count 3 0, 4 once, 5 0, and 6 and 7 should each be counted one time in my data. Once I've got this, now I can use the calculator function to find my five-number summary. Remember your five-number summary. Let's do this. Okay, your five-number summary is what we're looking for. Let's find it on the calculator first, and we'll fill them in. To do it on the calculator, what we're going to do is we're going to come over here, hit the stat button again, and we arrow over to calc because we want it to do the calculations for us. We're still doing one variable statistics because all we have is just pets' names. We won't even get into two variable statistics in this class. In this case, notice that my list that I want to pull the data from is L1. However, this time I have a frequency list that I'd like to pull my data from. I want to pull it from L2, so I'm going to put that in. So it says, don't just look at the data in the first one, but actually count how many of each I said. Then we can go down, hit the down arrow again, and we're going to choose calculate, and it'll find all of this information for me. Now, if you have a different calculator version, this is the TI-84 Plus. If you have a TI-83 Plus or TI-84, what you do is you still pick that one var stats, just like we did here, but the screen looks a little different. And then all you're going to do is you're going to type L1, which we got by hitting the second key in the 1. Then we're going to enter a comma, which is this button right here on your calculator. And then you're going to hit L2, which you do by going second there and then hit enter. So just what it looks like when you enter it is a little bit different. When you're done typing it in and it'll look just like this, then just hit the enter key, poof, and it'll look exactly like what we pull up right here on the screen. All right, so the five number summary we get by hitting the down arrow, because this doesn't give us anything we need. But we'll start to see what we need come up. The minimum, Q1, which is our first quartile, the median, Q3, which is our second quartile, and the maximum value here. So let's go ahead then and construct our box plot. Again, the box plot is essentially just we start with a number line as our base. So that's the first thing I'm going to do here. I'm going to draw a big old number line. So here we go. There's my number line base that I'm going to use. And then we'll go back here. Let's actually put some numbers in. In this case, we need numbers between 0 and 7, so we'll put those up here real quick. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Perfect. Okay, now we want to actually go in and create our box. So in this case, our box, we have the left side of our box is Q1, and that's happening at 1, so we put that in here. The right side of our box is Q3, which is this number right here. So you can kind of see that over here. So we come over here to Q3, which is occurring at 2, and that's going to be the right side of our box. In fact, let me write these here so we can kind of see them. So we start, oops, let's go back to freeform so we can write it. We start here with Q1, which is equal to 1. We have Q3, which is equal to 2, the left and right side of the box. So now I can go back over here. I can create the box by connecting the sides, poof, and there it is. Okay, the next thing that we need to do is find the median. Again, the median just shows up here in our list, and we can see it right here. The median is equal to 1. Now, this is kind of weird. The median is usually the middle of the box. In this case, the middle of my box ends up being exactly the same as what Q1 was. It does happen sometimes. We have, notice it's real heavily, our data is real heavily weighted right here. Usually we just make kind of a thicker line there to indicate that it's both Q1 as well as the median. So just kind of a strange case that happens sometimes. The next thing that we need to do once we've done the sides of our box and the center line or the median line, then we want to add our whiskers in. The whiskers happen at the minimum and at the maximum. The minimum occurs at the bottom of our data set here, min x, which is equal to 0. So that's going to be where our left whisker goes. The maximum is going to occur at our farthest box here, which is 7. So that's where our right whisker goes. Now, just click on our little line tool here. And again, if you're just sketching these on paper, just a quick sketch works perfectly. So I'm going to go from my Q1, the left side of my box, to the minimum, which was at 0. Poof, there's my first whisker. And then my second whisker goes from the right side of the box, Q3, all the way up to my maximum value, which in this case is 7. Okay, so there we go. And there's my box and whisker plot. Again, remember, each portion of these represents 25% of the data. So we've got 25% of the data that lies here between 0 and 1. We've got at least 25% of the data here at 1, because that's where both Q1 and the median were located. Then we've got another 25% of the data between 1 and 2. And then the last 25% of the data is stretched out in those values between 2 and 7. And you can kind of see that sort of a thing here from looking at this. Our data is real heavy up here at the left, and it spreads out real far at the right. And the box and whisker plot correlates in the way that that looks. So anyway, that's how you kind of translate from your histogram to your box and whisker plot, and we can do that using the stat button here, the edit function, and we can use the list by entering a frequency table with the values that we're measuring and then how often each of those values occur, and let the calculator do the work for you. Hope this helps, and good luck.